My name is Matthew Meyerson, and I'm a professor of pathology at Harvard Medical School, and my laboratory is focused on genomic analysis of lung cancer. I started working on lung cancer research when I joined the Dana-Farber faculty back in 1998, and at that time there were no foundations that specifically supported research in lung cancer. No foundations before the Lung Cancer Research Foundation that were actually dedicated to lung cancer research. So I was very excited when I heard about a solicitation from Jones Legacy, which was in honor of the late John Scarangello, who had been a patient with lung cancer, who had passed away. And so in 2003 I applied, and we were very fortunate to be awarded the first research grant from this foundation.
Well, my name is Marie Clay. I'm married to my high school sweetheart. We have two grown daughters, married to two wonderful gentlemen, and we have four beautiful grandchildren. I started experiencing some bone pain, back pain, muscle pain, and that's when he did an MRI and discovered that I had metastatic lung cancer. I had spots in my lung, in my ribs, and in my brain. When I was given that information, I thought, well, that's it. I'm done for. I was told that I was lucky enough to have the EGFR mutation in my cancer cells.
We were particularly interested in the fact that there was a distinct subtype of lung cancer seen in non-smokers, and we were trying to understand, you know, what was the role of that. So it actually started with a conversation with my colleague Bill Sellers, and he said, Matthew, why don't we sequence the kinase genes, or actually certain parts of the kinase genes, in lung and prostate cancers? And that's what we did. So in our lung cancer sequencing effort, I actually didn't think it was going to be a mutation in the EGFR gene, and that was kind of our good fortune. So that was the topic of our proposal. We showed that that mutation was present in the cancer, but not in the normal. So it was a somatic mutation, a mutation that arose during the development of the cancer. So this was incredible, and when we saw this, we thought, oh, this must be the reason for the response to gefitinib. We showed that mutations were present in those patients who had responded to gefitinib, but not in those patients who hadn't responded to gefitinib. And so this was really a kind of revolution in the lung cancer field.
There was a drug already developed and approved that inhibited the EGFR mutation in my cancer.
If we look at the 15-year history since the origin of the Lung Cancer Research Foundation, it's a remarkable change in lung cancer, both in our biological understanding and in the prevention and treatment of the disease.
It wasn't until last year when I saw a flyer promoting the Free to Breathe Lung Cancer Walk. And that's how I learned about the Lung Cancer Research Foundation and all the amazing work they were doing.
I think lung cancer remains a deadly and serious disease, but the progress in the 15 years since the establishment and origin of the Lung Cancer Research Foundation has been remarkable, and I'm really honored to have been a part of that evolution of the field.
I'm living with lung cancer as a chronic disease instead of a death sentence, and the more research we do, the more they will find out, and the longer people like me will get to live. If people can donate and help people affected by lung cancer live as long as they possibly can to fulfill their life's dreams and hopes, that would be just amazing, amazing. Without his discovery, I wouldn't be here. Please join me and help raise funds to support the Lung Cancer Research Foundation mission.